Well, now to our new series, 4 Minutes to Save the World. And this is where we try to solve some of your life's problems.
And this morning, a fairly common complaint. This is Lee's story.
I cry when the doctor put her on my stomach. I couldn't believe I created something so beautiful. She's not sleeping at all. I mean, when I say at all, I mean she's not sleeping enough. She sleeps 15 minutes, 5 minutes here and there, and she can be awake for up to 12 hours without any sleep, and that's what's worrying me. I love having her in my arms, but, you know, when she cries and cries for hours and hours and not sleep, I just, you know, you kind of just go, I want to give this up.
She puts a lot of strain on relationships, doesn't it? And Nat, you were in a very similar position, weren't you?
Sounding very similar. The problem I had was that a lot of the mothers' group said, oh yeah, we're doing that, and my cousin's kid did that, and you feel like, well, it must be normal, I just must have to put up with this. Mm. So we kind of did, and it was really, really hard.
Mm. And when you're tired, you just everything just goes down the tube.
Yep, exactly.
You can't cope. Well, after hearing Lee's story, we decided to send in some help. So we called baby expert Joe Ryan from babybliss.com.au. Now, surprisingly, the first thing that Joe did was look at Ashley's feeding habits. It turned out little Ashley is not drinking all her milk, but Joe proved that persistence makes all the difference.
Then Joe set about creating a routine for mum and bub. Most importantly, she passed on some much needed settling techniques. That was on Friday. Lee's had the weekend to start using these new techniques, so fingers crossed. Let's find out how she's coping. Lee joins us now along with baby expert Joe Ryan. Lee, good morning to you. All right, the weekend. Did you find a change? Have you slept better?
Yes, I have. She's gone to bed by herself as well, not in my arms, so with the whole family sleeping well.
Oh, that's good.
And that's it, isn't it? That's what you want to hear, the whole family. Joe, tell us about what you did, because this is an issue faced by parents everywhere. Yeah. You know, a new baby doesn't sleep, you don't get any sleep, everyone sort of, it spirals down from there.
Yeah. I think, Mel, it's just a few little sort of things that people really need to know, like that your new baby can't be awake for more than an hour at a time, and that's something that really no one tells you when you leave hospital with this baby. And so if they don't sort of naturally fall asleep, you've just got this baby sort of thinking, what am I going to do with it now, you know? So it's sort of, it has to be awake for an hour, and then within that hour, that's all the activity has to be done. So the feeding, the burping, the nappy changing, and then you have to settle the baby for sleep. You know, a lot of babies don't just conk out after the feed, so you've got to sort of wrap them and settle them and put them down and make sure they're ready to sleep.
Okay. Yeah. Now, does one routine fit every baby?
Well, for small babies, I'm not a huge fan of the sort of watching the clock routine, you know, like 10 a.m, 2 p.m, those sorts of things. But within that sort of 3 to 4 hourly cycles of, you know, sleep, feeding and then sleeping between feeds, yes, most new babies should fit to that routine, absolutely.
Okay.
You said that babies should be awake for an hour.
Yeah.
When they're little, and then they go to sleep. What if they don't go to sleep? What if you can't get them to sleep? Do you go all out and find different ways to do it? Do you take them for drives? Do you push them in the pram? I mean, it's kind of not, if you could make it sleep, that'd be great.
Exactly. And, you know, it's all very well to say, now put your baby to sleep, like the books say, but then they don't sleep. So I think that you need to be consistent in your settling technique, because a lot of people try something once and it doesn't work. And then so they try something different and the baby's just being more stimulated and they don't have a chance to learn the process. You know, they're like any human beings. They've got to be given time to learn something. So
they do actually learn the routine.
Yeah, they learn the process. Like, they start to become familiar with what you're doing. Like the wrapping, you know, before you put your baby down, that becomes the trigger. You know, they know when they're being wrapped, they're about to go to bed. So if you stick with something and you do it consistently the same way every time before they go to bed, they will start to understand and pick up and then become much more less sort of resistant.
Okay. Yeah. Now, Lee, you've noticed a really good change over just the weekend. Were you surprised at not how easy it is, but how just this routine makes such a huge difference? Had anyone told you about it?
No. Like Joe said, when I left the hospital, no one said she could only be awake for an hour and she should be sleeping 2.5 hours. You know, no one told us this. We assumed that when she's sleepy, she'll just go to sleep. and but that didn't happen. Now that we know there's a routine, what we should do, what we can and can't do, it's made it a lot easier.
Oh, well, it's just, it's wonderful to hear, because it is so hard and stressful for everybody concerned, and this is all you want is a sleeping baby. And particularly, a lot of people have babies at one, they'll have number one and it's perfect and it sleeps and it does everything, and then they have another one and it does exactly the opposite. So it can often make life a little bit hard. Joe, thank you for your advice to Lee and to all the other mums that obviously would have listened to it this morning. And Lee, all the best.
Thank you, thank you. I just want to say thanks to Sunrise and thanks to Joe. She's helped us a lot.
And let me tell you, you've got a very cute little baby too.
Look after her. I think so too.
Give her a cuddle for us.
We've got the Wiggles on the show tomorrow, so yeah, just, you know.
Well, I'll be hoping she'll be sleeping.
Yeah, that's true. Thank you. And for more information on getting your baby to sleep, head to the website, the Sunrise website. We've got all the information. We've got a link to Joe, just in case that you might need some extra help as well. So, yeah, hope it can help.